guitarist Miles Okazaki here. This is a video to go along with a book that I wrote called Fundamentals of Guitar. It looks like this, and it's out on Mel Bay Publications. I'm making some videos for things that are a little harder to see from the page, what they might be. Right now I'm looking at an exercise called the Scrambler. It's on page 35. Looks like this. You can see it's a grid, 12 by 12, and it looks kind of random, but actually there's a kind of order to it, which is that each row across and each column are 12 tone rows, meaning that they don't repeat any notes and they go through all 12 pitches. And also in the smaller boxes, the 3 by 4 boxes there that you can see that are connected by lines, those are each also 12 tone rows. So this is kind of a, I mean, you could write your own out, but this is, you know, this just provides a sort of a endless database of 12 tone rows for you to use for whatever purpose. In this exercise, I'm going through keys. So what I was doing there was, well, I was taking this first row, C, G flat, A, B flat, G, B, D flat, A flat, E flat, D, F, E. So that's the notes going across the top. La ho ho da ho ha ho ha ho ha ho 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 ha da da da. Let's see how close I was there. Yeah, pretty good. So you could warm up by trying to sing these rows. It's kind of a good pitch practice to warm up. And then maybe go to the instrument. Okay. There it is in its kind of lowest form. Maybe go up this way. That's higher. Maybe mix. Let's see. The same pitches, but I'm changing the octaves of some of them to get a more interesting shape. What I think is more interesting, anyway. Okay. It's kind of a funny fingering. So these could get you into, by doing this, you could get some fingering, some shapes that you might not have normally stumbled upon. So I'm just going through the row and getting it kind of in my mind, in my fingers a little bit, putting a rhythm on it, whatever. Accents. Exercise the Scrambler, which I don't know. I showed this to you before we worked on this.
We did some stuff with it.
Anyway, yeah. It's just all it is randomized key centers and trying to get some facility of moving through keys in one position. And so before you got here, I did a little single note thing. And then, so what you could also think of these as opposed to being like single notes, like a tone row we were doing. Be single pitches like that, but they could also represent other things, like they could represent keys, for example. So one of the most basic things to get the sound of the key is that pentatonic scale. So I could play something like Thank you. playing pentatonic scales in this general region of the guitar, low region, like second, third position. And I was playing through the keys of that same row. So I could, you may not have been able to hear it, but now you'll be able to hear it better with Ed playing roots, playing those as roots, right? So we'll play them low, like two notes each. Say that these are going to be like scales, or we could say they're going to be minor tonalities, like I'll play a Dorian scale with a major seventh on each of these, or I'll try to. So that'd be like a melodic minor scale. The first one would be... All right. Let's do the same tempo. One, two, three. So that you get all the different ways of getting through the keys, and it's also kind of an improvisational way to do it rather than just, you know, pounding through the scales. Yeah. All right. Thanks for checking out this video. Thanks to Ed for stopping by, and see you next time. All right. One thing I forgot to say was to explain what I was doing in the beginning of the tape. That was pentatonics, like I just demonstrated with Ed, going through these key centers. In low position, just in kind of trying to go through all those keys right around here. Let's see, right? La, that was the idea. The only thing that may be a little bit harder to hear is the rhythm, which is nobody else is playing it, so I was just hearing it internally, and that was a rhythm, not a four beat thing like I did in the with Ed, but something based on a rhythmic figure. It sounds like this. So you can see where the cycle starts. Anyway, that's what that was. I went through the row two times for that improvisation. So if you go back and play that rhythmic figure along with what I was playing, you can probably hear how it's moving around in the keys.